All right, I want to talk a little bit about chemical nomenclature, but looking at a specific example. I hope you're getting familiar and getting more comfortable using those polyatomic ions and making formulas and ionic compounds with those polyatomic ions. But heaven forbid your instructor should request that you memorize those polyatomic ions. What we're talking about today is actually going to help you as you learn the names of those. It's going to help you remember them. What we have listed here are the six strong acids. There are some lists that actually include a seventh acid, but I'm going to focus on these six as we go through this. It is in your best interest to learn these six strong acids, learn that they are strong acids. They're strong acids because they're strong electrolytes. Learn the names of them as well as the formula. And again, if you memorize these six, it's going to help you go a long way to remembering a lot of the other things that we have to name. They're all covalent compounds, which means they're made up of nonmetals only. However, we do not name them like we name covalent compounds. They have their own special naming system. If we named HCl, for example, as we would name a covalent compound, we'd call it hydrogen monochloride, but nobody calls this hydrogen monochloride. If we name it as a pure substance, we call it hydrogen chloride. This is hydrogen bromide, hydrogen iodide. It's named more like an ionic compound is named, even though these aren't ionic compounds. The NO3 with a negative 1 is the nitrate ion, so we would call this hydrogen nitrate if we were just naming it as a pure substance. We almost always want to name these as acids, and as an acid, this is called hydrochloric acid. So as an acid, this is called hydrochloric acid. As an acid, this is called hydroiodic acid. All right, let's focus on these three for a minute. We see some patterns. The first pattern we see is that all of them begin with the hydro prefix. After that hydro prefix, the next part of the name is indicative of the element with hydrogen. Hydrogen with the chlorine, the bromine, and the iodine. So chloric, bromic, iodic. Another thing that we see as far as the pattern is that the last letters after the stem for the element are ic, it is ic, so hydrochloric acid. And we also do include the word acid in the name of these compounds. That's how we would name these binary acids, an acid made up of hydrogen and one other element. Now let's focus on the last three strong acids. The bottom line is, if you're asked to, you must memorize the names of these acids, and it's in your best interest to do that, so you should. This next one on our list is called nitric acid. The next one on the list is called perchloric acid. And the last one on our list is called sulfuric acid. Now, as we start analyzing these, you'll notice that none of them have the hydro prefix. None of them have that hydro prefix. We do not use the hydro prefix when we're naming acids that are made up of hydrogen and a polyatomic ion. There is no hydro prefix for these. You just simply must memorize it. The first part for the name of the acid is related to that polyatomic ion. And nitric acid is made up of hydrogen and the nitrate ion, which is NO3 with a minus 1 charge. This is the nitrate ion. Whenever we have an acid made up of a polyatomic ion that ends in 8, A-T-E, the acid is an ic acid. So nitrate ion gives us nitric acid. Notice that the charge is minus 1, and so we need one hydrogen with that acid. HNO3 is nitric acid. Perchloric acid is made up of the perchlorate ion. The perchlorate ion is ClO4 with a minus 1 charge. Perchlorate ion gives us perchloric acid. And again, the charge is minus 1. We have one hydrogen ion. The last one, sulfuric acid, is made up of the sulfate ion, SO4, and the SO4 has a negative 2 charge. SO4 negative 2 is the sulfate ion, and it gives us the sulfuric acid. There are two hydrogens because it's got a negative 2 charge. So it's sort of like ionic compounds where they're needed to balance, but it's not an ionic compound. It's a covalent compound, but it's in the special category of acids. So we have here some that we can memorize that will help us memorize those particular ions, the sulfate ion, the perchlorate ion, the nitrate ion. As we look at some other common acids that we might use in the laboratory, one common weak acid is H3PO4. H3PO4 is phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is made up of the polyatomic ion, that is the phosphate ion. PO4 with a negative 3 charge, this is the phosphate ion, and it gives us phosphoric acid. The 8 ions always give us ic acids. Notice that the phosphoric acid has a negative 3 charge, and that's why we need 3 hydrogens. Again, kind of like ionic compound, even though it's not an ionic compound. If you memorize H3PO4 as phosphoric acid, you have the phosphate ion memorized. All right, now to extend this. When we have polyatomic ions, we know that they can vary not only in what atoms make them up, but the number of oxygen ions. For example, let's go back to that phosphate ion that we were just looking at. It is PO4 with a negative 3, or 3 minus charge. And when it forms the acid, then we get H3PO4 for the phosphoric acid. There is another ion that is made up of phosphoruses and oxygens, and it's the PO3, which also has a negative 3 charge. The charge stays the same. The PO3 with a negative 3 charge is not a phosphate ion, it's the phosphite ion. This guy is the 8 ion. The PO3 with a negative 3 is the ite ion. But again, it forms an acid, but now it's just H3PO3. It's still H3 because of the negative 3 charge, but it's only a PO3 because it's the phosphite ion. And when I name this second acid, remember this guy was phosphoric acid, this one has to have a slightly different name, and it's called phosphorus acid. It is O-U-S for the ending, and the saying is that ite becomes us. Ate becomes ick when you're dealing with an acid, ite becomes us. And so you can see how if you just memorize a few acids' names, then you can learn the names of the polyatomic ions, they start to make more sense to you, they're all related, and hopefully that helps you as you do your nomenclature.